boundary scan test system obviously needs information about the board it's testing. Without basic data, it can't know, for example, which pins it can safely drive or where to check for resulting signal changes. In this video series, I'm going to show you the best way to get circuit data into XJ Developer, some tips on how to do that as effectively as possible, and some warnings of potential pitfalls. Having some sort of netlist is the most important. It is possible to enter board information manually, but for this video, I'll be assuming you have a netlist available. You'll also benefit greatly from a BOM and schematic for reasons I'll explain in the next couple of videos. But for now, I want to talk about netlists, their different formats, and how to import them. First, though, let me show you around the Add Boards dialog box. It's the main place you need to go for entering board data. It gets launched automatically when you create a new project. Or you can go to the board screen in XJ Developer and click New down the bottom here. You could give your board a name right now, but if you leave this field blank, the system will automatically fill it for you later with a netlist name, which can be helpful because it will often include the file revision being used. If you've got a multi-board system though, give it some sort of useful name. This description field is optional for free text. I'll be talking about importing a BOM and adding a schematic in the next two videos, but for now, let's concentrate on this middle section where we enter netlist details. First of all, I think I need to talk about netlist formats. XJTAG supports loads of different formats, but the most useful is ODB++. That's because ODB++ allows XJTAG to use its layout viewer to highlight specific nets. That can be really helpful, not just while you're developing a project in the first place, but also when it comes to board testing, where it aids debug by displaying any faults on a view of your PCB. However, if you're at an early stage of development and haven't yet done the layout, you won't have ODB++ available. So get going with whatever format you've got and update it later. The beauty of starting early is that you can then do design for test work with the boundary scan software up front before you've committed to a PCB design. In terms of ASCII netlists, XJ Developer supports over 80 different formats, but let me add a warning about one of them. It's probably not a good idea to use EDIF. It is supported, but some of the common EDA tools produce EDIF files that contain such major syntax errors that it can be impossible to get meaningful data from them. So best to avoid that format if you can. Okay, let's get back to the Add Board dialog box to see how to import files. ODB++ first, and there are two forms in which you might get this netlist. It could come in a compressed format, such as a zip file, or it might be in the form of a set of cascaded directories. If it's a compressed file, use the Browse button to locate it, or if it's an uncompressed directory structure, use this Browse ODB++ directory button instead to choose the directory at the top of the structure. Either way, when you click Select, XJ Developer will examine the netlist, and if it finds embedded BOM data, you'll be offered the option to extract it. I'll be talking specifically about BOMs in part 3 of this series, but for now, let me just say that if you've got a separate BOM file, it's probably best to click No at this point. There are two reasons for this. Firstly, a BOM associated with a netlist will normally include all the components, whether or not they've been placed during assembly, whereas a separate BOM is probably going to be a better reflection of what was actually built. Secondly, the quality of BOM data embedded in netlists is very dependent on what the schematic capture tools added, and it can often be incomplete. So it's normally best not to extract data at this point. Now let's move on and look at importing ASCII files. Simply use the same Browse button to locate it, and XJ Developer will automatically try to identify its format. If it doesn't recognize the format, you'll see Invalid appear in the Format field, but no need to panic. Simply email your netlist to support@xjtag.com and the team will convert it to a supported format for you and then add support into the next release. But as I said, the software already supports over 80 formats, so you shouldn't have a problem. With a valid ASCII format in place, click Open, and if XJ Developer finds any embedded BOM data, you'll again be offered the chance to import it. As with ODB++ files, if you've got a separate BOM, it's probably best to click No at this point. You can always extract its BOM data later. Whichever format you're using, give XJTAG a few moments to import the file. And then it's done. That's the netlist imported. The next steps in getting circuit data into XJDeveloper are to add a schematic and import a BOM, and I'll talk about those in the next two videos. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please subscribe for more and leave a like or a comment below.